Year of the Witching by Alexis Henderson is a supernatural horror adult book, which is a little bit deceptive because this book feels like a YA novel. What I mean, though, is that when the book is described, they say it's an adult novel with YA crossover appeal. And I think that's BS because a lot of the YA tropes kind of leaked out on the page when I was reading it. But let's get into the plot. This book is about Emmanuel. She is a biracial woman living in a puritanical town called Bethel, where everyone's about, you know, piety and, you know, being part of the Father. Everyone's ruled by prophets. Prophets are like the leaders that are like ultimate authority, and all of the, you know, the underlings. And the people are very, you know, super pseudo-religious to the point of, you know, this woman's really good with herbs, burn her at the stake kind of thing. And Emmanuel has a lot of emotional baggage because her mother is Miriam Moore. She was a woman who laid with a black man. He was burned at the stake. She ran into the dark wood, supposedly came out pregnant with the man's child, and that child is Emmanuel. So she's got this social stigma on her, also the fact that she's biracial. Most of the black people in their community live in the outskirts of sorts. They're sort of pushed away. So she's living with her mother's side of the family. There's her grandfather, grandmother, aunt, and nieces. So she lives a very simple life until one day she's walking to the market with a goat. She goes to the Darkwood by accident, and she basically gets propositioned by four witches that live in the dark woods. And that is the concept of Year of the Witching. That's what sort of gave, found out about this book from Regan from Peru's Project on YouTube, and she pitched it, and the concept sounded pretty good. It's about basically a young woman basically discovering witchcraft and using it against, you know, the super religious town. However, they really push on the romance aspect with another character named Ezra, and the main girl doesn't have that much character development herself or motivation. But what I really didn't like was that the book tries way too hard in terms of tone. The book repeatedly tries to like paint a picture of like a grotesque horror constantly all the time, though, and it got really like tiresome. It's like if you're watching a movie about witchcraft and you see this like, shot of a meadow, and then all of a sudden they cut to like a decaying fox head and like maggots eating an apple and like dark skies and rain and mud, and they do that like every 5 minutes to try to like sell the fact that, you know, the sereneness will be broken by gross stuff. That's kind of like what reading this book feels like. They try way too hard to try to push forward the sort of you know, tone of like scary. I was already like into it because of the whole dark wood aspect and the whole rituals and the whole sort of magic system of sorts. The book does pick up a little bit, and then the third act gets really melodramatic. I didn't really like the shifting tones. You know, one moment it's like a supernatural thriller, then it's a romance, then they're trying to go for like action, and just a lot of melodramatic moments at the end, especially the whole people being like, no, take me instead. No, take me instead. And I just, oh, got really all over the place. That's why I feel it has the YA vibes. And I'm not knocking YA. I'm just saying that the book felt a little tropey. And I felt like, you know, it could have been, you know, a lot better. I just feel like the book just sort of, you know, focused way too much on the romance and the convenience of the plot. And then the third act was very rushed. I'm just going to open the book to a random spot and see if I can find the overly grotesque stuff. Here we go. Found a passage. Chapter 8. That night, Emmanuel dreamed of the forest. In sleep, she conjured visions of the Dark Mother wandering the corridors of the woodland, cradling a slaughtered lamb in her arms, her black veil trailing through the brush. She dreamed of scarecrow witches burning like torches in the night, tangled limbs and stolen kisses. In her nightmare, she saw the lovers toiling in the dirt, grasping at each other, teeth bared, pale eyes sharp with moonlight. When she woke, she was sweating cold, the back of the nightdress damp, clinging to her shoulders like a second skin. She sat up dizzied, her heart tapping a sharp rhythm against her ribs. Her ears rang with a plaintive bleating. So, I mean, that's not one of the examples I could think of, to be honest. Well, they try to do stuff like that, but, you know, it should just be like sitting down watching she'll be like going for a walk, and then she'll have like a vision of darkness, and then like someone will be like, "Are you okay, Emmanuel?" And she'll be like, "Yes, yes, I'm fine." You know, like dream sequences over and over, gets kind of boring. Also, there's the weird name thing. Her father's name is like Daniel Ford, or is it David Ford? And then like the first prophet was Daniel Ward. No, see, that's the thing. All these names. Okay, I'm pretty sure her dad's name is Daniel Ward, but the first prophet's name was David Ford. And it confused the hell out of me because they're both, one of them is white, one of them is a black man, and but their names are so similar with the D and the four letters for the last name. So I didn't really like, it's like if you have a book with too many characters with the same name with starting with a B, you know, Bart, Bob, you know, Betty, Brant, you know, things like that. So The Year of the Witching is a novel that isn't awful. I mean, I did read it. It was kind of slow, and it picks up around the 90-page mark, and it's about 400 pages. I just didn't like the sort of weakness of the motivations of the characters, the over usage of trying to make it bleak and atmospheric, and the rushed and melodramatic third act. But overall, though, I mean, I read it. It's not awful, and it's a debut of the author, so she can only get better from here. So that's what I feel about The Year of the Witching by Alexis Henderson.